jokers, folks, this ain't no dang jokers. My fourth biggest investment in the stock market. Yes, my fourth biggest investment in the stock market. Corsair Gaming, CRSR stock, reported earnings a few hours ago, okay? Now, we've got to talk about some things in regards to the stock, okay? The first thing we're going to get into in this video is the earnings results and my opinion on those results, okay? Then we're getting into some strange stuff, and I mean some very strange stuff that happened in regards to the stock price here today, okay? We'll get into that. And the third thing we're going to get into is, did I buy this stock here today? Did I sell this stock here today? And if I did so, at what time period did I do it, and why did I do it at that particular time period, okay? So yes, we're going to get into a lot in regards to Corsair Gaming in this video here today. All I ask in return is that you guys smash that thumbs up button, and that's literally it, guys. This is a stock that I've been buying heavily the past several months. Okay, I'm planning to hold the stock over the next several years, and needless to say, like, you know, when it's my fourth biggest investment, it's gonna move my accounts if it's positive or negative. Okay, now Hungry Ball, if you haven't downloaded it yet on your iOS and Android store, do so now. The earnings call should be up there for Corsair Gaming at some point tonight here, so if you're looking to listen to that earnings call right inside the app, do enjoy that, guys, as always. So yeah, Hungry Ball, it's on your iOS and Android store now and is absolutely free to use. I hope you enjoy that, as always. All right, now first thing to remember in regards to Corsair Gaming is they did report some of their numbers, okay? And so that's why the stock price got hit in a major way. They pre-announced essentially some very bad numbers. And so a lot of that news was baked into the stock going in. And this is something to just keep in mind in regards to stocks in the future, okay? If it's a stock that is a beaten down dog and it has so much, let's just call it negative numbers already pre-announced and things like that, it doesn't mean it can't go down more. It just means that there's you're starting to get to a point where any bit of good news will send the stock price up rather than down, okay? And so it's just some food for thought here in regards to Corsair Gaming and future stocks, okay? Now, in regards to the financials here, all right? The first thing we like to look at is year-over-year quarterly numbers. Bad. Net revenue down 14%. Bad. Gross profit down 20% plus. Bad. Gross profit margin down 210 basis points. Bad. Operating income down 78%. Adjusted operating income down 57%. Net income down 95%. Earnings per share down 95%. Adjusted net income down 66%. Everything bad, 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 bad. Okay? Really bad. Just, there's no other way of putting it other than bad, okay? Just horrible numbers across the board here. However, the stock has been beaten down, so a lot of this was already baked in. Now, before we get to the year-over-year numbers, first thing I want to know is, why was everything so dang bad, okay? Corsair Gaming, okay, Corsair gained market share in almost every category through Q3 2021. What does that mean to me? That means the categories that Corsair was, you know, basically competing in are garbage in the short term, right? Not long term. We all obviously know these things are going to continue to grow and grow and grow for years to go in the future. But in the short term, like, in order for Corsair's numbers to go down that much, but they also gain market share, means like the categories just had a horrible quarter. A horrible quarter. That's what that means in the most simple plain English possible, okay? Q3 net revenue was impacted by availability of reasonably priced GPUs, which curtailed the demand for new PC builds and its components, which we know Corsair Gaming benefits in a massive way from new PC builds. High logistics costs, including ocean and air freight, had an impact on Q3 margins, resulting in gross profit margin of 25.9% compared to, you know, where it had previously been, you know, year to date, 28.1, okay? The Jeremy translation on this is essentially, we were screwed by Rona comps, right? They had a comp with Rona numbers year over year. They were screwed by overpriced GPUs, and they were screwed by transportation costs, right? And they did steal business from others. So yeah, that's basically the Jeremy translation there. No bueno, okay? Now, in terms of year-over-year numbers, as far as year-to-date, net revenue up 21%, gross profit up 25%, gross profit margin up 90 basis points, operating income up 13.4%, adjusted operating income up 16.6%, net income up 26%, earnings per share diluted up 10%, adjusted net income up 19%, and adjusted EBITDA up 13%. So needless to say, year-to-date numbers, extremely impressive from Corsair Gaming. The quarterly numbers, trash, okay? So trash for this past quarter, great for the overall year. So even when you account for this trash quarter, the numbers are still dang impressive as far as the yearly numbers there, okay? So that's the base numbers. Now, in terms of their main business, that's gaming components and systems. As far as this business, net revenue was down almost 15%. As far as the percent of total net revenue, down about 30 basis points. Gross profit down 22% there. Year-over-year numbers, very, very strong, but obviously this quarter, year-over-year numbers, no bueno, right? The entire industry was impacted by GPU shortages, which caused retail prices to surge 150% plus of MSRP, guys. So needless to say, GPU shortage like made pricing go ridiculous. Like, doesn't even make sense, right? And when that happens, it's gonna hurt Corsair's business model, right? This caused many enthusiasts to hold off building a performance gaming PC. And I can understand if prices surge 150% plus, I can understand that. We believe that as GPUs become more available over the next few quarters, there's a pent-up demand for building high-performance gaming PCs. Corsair managed to grow market share in every component category through Q3. This is something important to remember in regards to Corsair's business model. It's a business model that goes through some crazy bull cycles and some vicious bear cycles, okay? It really does. And in regards to right now, in the short term, it's going through a kind of, we don't know if this is going to last one quarter, two quarters, three quarters, four quarters, but we know it's just like, it's not good right now, right? And eventually, things are going to turn for the better. Whether it takes a quarter or two for things to turn for the better, we'll have to see how long it takes. But needless to say, the stock price has already been damaged in a heavily way. Gamer and creator peripherals, which has been a nice growing market for the company, right? Net revenue is down 13.8%. Gross profit down 19%. So numbers aren't quite as bad, but needless to say, not great, right? Q3 net revenue was impacted by IC shortages, which caused our premium high-value products to be in tight supply. Q3 segment gross profit margins were impacted by increased logistic costs as well as reduced sales in premium products. So needless to say, right now in this quarter, it was just a rough one. But keep in mind, look at the year-to-date numbers here, guys. Year-over-year up 35%, up 340 basis points. Gross profit up 42%. Gross profit margin up 180 basis points. So essentially, the year-to-date numbers, phenomenal. Right now in the short term, these quarterly numbers, just bad, okay? There's no, I don't like to sugarcoat numbers. They're just bad numbers in the very, very short term here. But year to date, there's no denying that the numbers are incredibly impressive. Revenue growth guidance for the rest of this year, which is only one quarter left, they're expected to do $1.82 billion to $1.92 billion, at 7 to 13% revenue growth there. Adjusted operating income is expected to come in at 180 to 195 mil. Adjusted EBITDA is expected to come in at 190 to 205 million dollars. So as far as analysts, they have this company having revenue growth of about 10% this year. Next year, about 8.8%, probably because it's coming off of a lower number. And keep in mind, since Q3 and Q4 are likely going to be rough quarters, the year-over-year comps for those quarters should be easier for Corsair Gaming to put up some incredible numbers, especially if GPUs like stop going stupidly high, right? And so needless to say, yeah, it's a rough one in the short term, but so much of that has been priced into the stock, okay? And look at what the stock's doing today, obviously the bad news has been pretty much baked in this one. Debt summary in regards to this: cash of almost $72 million, term loan 250 mil, total debt 250 mil, net debt 178 mil there. Okay, now in Q3, this is very important. In Q3 20, this is important for long-term investors. As far as somebody who's short-term trading this stock, you don't care about debt because you're not going to be around in the stock. You might be around for the next week or the next month, but you're not going to be around for this long term. For somebody like myself as a long-term shareholder, this stuff matters. Okay, in Q3 2021, refinanced long-term debt, substantially reducing the interest rate, doubled the revolver to 100 mil, and reduced outstanding debt by $24 million to $250 million of face value. Based on our current net leverage ratio, our interest rate on the long-term debt is LIBOR plus 1.25%. So not bad at all for long-term debt. That's actually really, really impressive. And the company does expect to reduce debt over time, okay? And so once again, for long-term investors, something like this is absolutely very, very important. Now, as far as some new product launches they had in the past quarter, they have some big ones that, once again, for long-term investors like myself, these are important things, guys, okay? They launched into streaming cameras for the first time, We introduced our Elgato Facecam, which expanded our creative solutions and entered a $1 billion plus webcam market. This is a massive, massive market. And so for them to enter this, guys, is huge for a company like Corsair Gaming, right? Elgato leverages 15 plus years of experience in video to design a camera that meets the growing needs for content creators. Facecam bridges the gap between a webcam and a professional camera by combining state-of-the-art optics with purpose-built software, unlocking powerful customization and seamless integration into the broader Elgato ecosystem. And from my, what I have seen from a lot of people's opinion on this camera, very, very high. Like the far majority of folks I have seen that have tried this product are like, yeah, two thumbs up, love the product, needless to say. It is better than most webcams you will find out there, but it's not quite up to like a DSLR's capability, right? But remember, most DSLRs, you know, that are really good ones run $1,000 or $3,000, right? This is a product that is, priced at a couple hundred bucks. So this is something to remember. I think this opportunity in the webcam market is absolutely massive for Elgato over the next 5-10 years. And so, yeah, I love them entering this market and, look for some unbelievably impressive numbers from that market for this company for years to go in the future, right? New category, gaming monitor. They just got into the gaming monitor space. They launched basically a 32-inch high refresh rate that has AMD FreeSync compatibility for the gaming monitor. This is huge, guys. This is entering a TAM of $4 billion plus dollars, right? They don't have to be the winner in gaming monitors. As long as they build a solid business that has, $100 million to, like, let's say $300 million of, sales, guys, like, this is the type of stuff that's game changers for Corsair. This is the type of stuff that can push them over numbers year over year and get them to beat numbers, right, and get the stock price moving in the right direction. So this is huge stuff. I don't think a lot of folks realize how big these things are and how big the TAM is Corsair is going after in these markets, right? New technology, DDR5 memory. After 7 years of DDR4, both Intel and AMD are poised to make the switch to DDR5 in 2022. The new DDR5 technology launch will enable a surge of upgrades with potential increase in ASPs. That's very important. Average selling prices increase, and then average selling prices is extremely important. We cannot understate that, okay? We believe Corsair will be at the forefront of performance leadership with this new technology introduction. With a strong launch lineup, we expect to continue our market dominance in this category, currently at over 50% market share in major markets. Guys, this is massive. So, I mean, as a long-term shareholder, I'm looking at this and I'm nothing but excited. If I was just judging this company off a quarterly basis, I'd be like, boo, these numbers stink, right? But when you look at the year-to-date numbers, and when you look at like how many new product categories, gaming monitors now getting into, the massive webcam market that's just going to continue to expand exponentially over the coming years, right? DDR5 memory, like, you cannot like understate how big these opportunities are for Corsair Gaming on just the coming years, right? New controller with their SCUF gaming product, essentially, for the Xbox, Series X. So needless to say, I'm so pumped about these new product launches for this company over the coming years. It's absolutely ridiculous, right? Now, let's go ahead and address the elephant in the room, the stock price, and if I'm buying the stock, selling the stock, and why I'm doing so, okay? So first off, the stock was moving in pre-market, right? And going into market open, boom, 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 it opens great. It looks like it's going to be a great day for Corsair Gaming, which kind of makes sense because, like I said, all you need is a glimmer of good news in relation to a beaten down dog stock to get the stock price to move up big, right? And then right after, it just tanks. I mean, absolutely tanks, boom, 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 for the next, hour in the market, essentially, just do, 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 do. And, that's something that a lot of us know of the Eagle Tree Fund or whatever they're called, right? And how many shares they hold of the stock. And it's like, did they just dump shares on the market? Or we hate to blame them, but it's like a lot of us think that. It's like, did they just dump shares just to kill the stock price? It doesn't make sense why they would do that, but we can't deny the fact that it's a possibility, right? Because if you're a long-term investor in this company, There's no reason for you to have sold this stock today. We all knew they pre-announced the numbers, so we all knew they were going to be bad numbers, right? As far as on the short term here. We all know of the exciting product launches and things like that. There was nothing to like give a sell out of this stock. And if anything, I feel like retail investors were buying this up as the trading day kind of went on, right? It's just very strange that the stock was, you know, set to have a really good day and that just all of a sudden crazy selling pressure. The buying pressure could not hold this stock up. It didn't matter how many buyers you had in the market. It was just too much dang selling pressure. And next thing you know, over the course of an hour, the stock goes from, you know, nearly $27 to it was trading at $24.50 roughly, right? And I think at the lows today, I think it might even have reached a 23 something at some point today, right? Very, very suspect. That's all we'll say about that. Like the amount of selling pressure that just came onto the stock was rather immense there, okay? Once again, we know Corsair Gaming has a massive, massive short interest behind the stock, okay? Now, in terms of me, did I buy the stock? Did I sell the stock? Things like that today, okay? Well, usually I'm not going to buy at an open, right? Because you just never know if suspect stuff happens like this. And this is why I don't like to buy at the open, right? I don't like to put in orders the night before usually. Usually I like to buy during the trading day when things have kind of, you know, let's just say normalized, because you get some suspect activity like that where it's just like, whoo, pfft. So what I ended up doing is I did end up buying some Corsair Gaming, but I waited till way later in the trading day to do this. I bought 200 shares of Corsair Gaming for $25.04. As far as me, I feel like for the most part, Corsair Gaming has the boogeyman out, right? Now, of course, you could say, well, what if the market drops 10, 15%? Sure, Corsair could drop, but so couldn't every stock in the stock market drop if the market just drops 10, 15%, okay? As far as Corsair Gaming, I feel like the boogeyman's out now. Everybody is prepped for bad numbers next quarter, right? And maybe even in Q1 of, basically 2022. So everybody is now prepared mentally to see bad numbers this upcoming quarter and bad numbers in Q1 of 2022. So the question is, okay, now that you're mentally prepared for bad numbers, all you need is a little something good and the stock's ready to fly, right? Like a coiled spring. So that's why I'm like, I'm going to go ahead and buy some more shares in this one as somebody that's a long-term huge believer in the stock. Nothing that's going on short term deters me from the long term opportunity in Corsair Gaming, right? And so that's why I bought. And like I said, I waited till later in the trading day because, yeah, you get suspect stuff that happens right early in the trading day where that stock spiked up for the first 10, 15 minutes of the market trading and then just shot down for the next 1 to 1.5 hours, right? And no one really knows, like, why did that happen? All we know is crazy selling pressure came on it. So needless to say, in regards to Corsair Gaming, as a long-term shareholder, I'm happy. As somebody that's looking at the stock from a short-term perspective, I would not be happy because the numbers just aren't good there, right? They're just not good, and they're likely not going to be good anytime soon, at least for the next 1 to 2 quarters. And hopefully in the middle part to the back half of 22, those numbers and those trends start to reverse in a major way. And all of a sudden you start seeing some nice growth again, which I fully expect. Now, the wild card with Corsair Gaming, this is a wild card, okay, is if there's any major game launches or any games that come out that all of a sudden get the whole gaming community going crazy, that's that one thing that you got to look at, and that's always a potential. And when those sorts of things happen, like, you know, a Fortnite type game or, you know, any sort of big game changing game to come out that just gets the whole community going crazy, right? Those things are massive boosts for Corsair Gaming in their business model, their underlying business model. Do we get one of those? I don't know. I'm not betting my money that we're going to get one of those. However, we can't deny the fact that all it would take is one massive game that gets everybody going wild, and the next thing you know, Corsair Gaming, his business is all of a sudden, boop, like that, okay? So it's just some food for thought there in regards to Corsair Gaming. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, all I ask in return is that you smash the thumbs up button. That helps out huge YouTube algorithm, guys. I appreciate each and every one of you that's part of the thumbs up squad. Also, Hungry Bull, if you haven't downloaded it yet, it is absolutely free to do so. That's on your iOS and Android store now. Track your stocks. Listen to Corsair earnings calls, plus a past earnings calls as well. Get the SEC reports. Look at the financials. All that good stuff, guys. Much love as always, and have a great day.